happens here. Think we're in Hunrath anymore. Okay, we are here, and actually, if you were paying attention, there was enough information in those books in Farley's home to actually for us to surmise that this is Murray, the home of the villain. But unfortunately, we ended up swapping out here. But just a little bit down this way, there's a barrier that we can't get past. So really, we're just left with swapping back to Hunrath, which is okay. The button's over here on this side. This would be one of those ambassador seeds that was talked about in the books. In the last episode in Farley's house. Rather similar to the going through the books in Mist, I would say. There we go. And I do like this effect of it coalescing back to where we were. Okay, we are back in Hunrath now. What I was about to do, yeah, I gotta go through this way. There's a couple of things I do want to accomplish. Gets us to here. I want to get this bridge swung over so that I can cross here for sure, so we'll do that. But then, other than that, there's really nothing for us to do here. So we are now, where are we? Oh, I see, we're at the back of Farley's, yep. We're almost at the back of Farley's. But what I want to do is head down to that number thing and find out what that... Here, I'll show it to you in the photos. Photos. This here, this sort of 15, I guess is the way I'm looking at it. Code that I think connects to the door that is located right here. So if we can find out what that number is in our number system, I'm hoping that will be the code that will get us through that door. Alright, so here we are back at the gas station. Alright, so let's take out my old crap here. Now, that's 15. Given that there are some sort of blanks here, places where there aren't nodes here on the side, I was rotating the projector back and forth, but there really is only one way I can see to actually enter in the 15, which is like this. Because if you slide this left or right, you end up with nodes in places where there are no nodes. So this is the only thing I can see to put in here. So let's put this in, see what we get. 406. Let's take a snap of that. Now notice actually that this pattern has actually changed. This confused me for a little bit because, well, after full confession, full disclosure, I am a math teacher. So as soon as I saw that number system, I went and said to myself, okay, well, you know, let's translate that 15 to a number without using this machine. And it really can't be done. It doesn't translate into the numericals. This is actually the right pattern for 406. 406 in base 4 is 12112. That is 2 in the ones column, which is this symbol right here. 1 in the fours column, which is this symbol right there. 1 in the 16s column, which interestingly, if you start playing around with the machine, because translating up 1 goes off the machine, it actually rotates. It goes from, this is the first column, the first digits, this is the second digits, then the next 16s digit is here. This is 1 in the 16s digit there. Then it's 2 in the 64's digit, that would be the next place value, and 2 in the 64's digit is right here. It takes this 2 and translates it down to here. That's the fourth place value. Again, if you notice, it's rotating around is what's happening. And then 1 in the 256 or fifth place value is this symbol right here. So this is actually 406 written correctly, but maybe the machine's designed to teach you and go, no, that's not right. This is probably what you were shooting for. I don't know. But anyway, 406, that's the number to remember. So let's get ourselves back to where that code was. And I'm hoping that this code is, put that up, 406. Ah! Nice. Okay, we are inside here with more stuff to explore. Let's first take a look. Here's a door. Okay. Nope. Is this the door part? What's the door? There we go. Oh, and this gets, we were here before. This is the entrance into the tree, which we have to still figure out how to get to, but at least that gives us a way through here. And what about on, there's a door over there. Lock through. Oh, and here we are. That's the big sphere. There's the junkyard, railroad station. So hopefully people can see where we are. So this is another way through the big wall, rock wall that's between us. Excellent. Vote for Mayor Joseph. Yeah, we've seen a lot of his videos. What do we got here? Mayors. History of mayors. Luther, John Farley, Caroline Farley. So Caroline Farley, we've seen in videos as well, or messages. And then Joseph, our present mayor. Let's see what we have. There was obviously some sort of campaign going on here. Yeah, so you can keep an eye on the tree, I guess. I don't know. Now we got an elevator. Okay, I'll get to that in a little bit. Let's look around, see what else. Oh, I can see some notes down this way. Mr. Mayor, at your behest, here is the information pertaining to the bleeder, its history, and some of the engineering behind it. The bleeder project was designed and built at the request of Mayor Sims to collect and dissipate the ever-increasing power in the entire ecosystem. Mayor Sims was reluctant to allow the system to come to fruition as he and others had become suspicious of Mayor Farley's death. Ooh. He believed that without knowing more precisely what would happen to the cell wall at fruition, it was ill-advised to allow it to possibly open, thus allowing what might be outside in and what might be inside out. The system has the capacity to throttle all four connected worlds. The idea, as you are well aware, is to suppress the ecosystem power and thus inhibit full maturity of the trees. It was postulated and since become apparent that this suppression will keep whatever unknown maturity process was from happening and grant us direct control over free tree fruition. As you know, we discourage swimming when the bleeder is in operation. Regards, CW. Now the bleeder, in case you didn't, so as you can actually see, it's labeled on the map. The bleeder is, oh, I can't quite see it from here, is this big contraption here that's sitting in that lake. So that's what they are referring to. Okay. No more notes down this way. Let's look up. I guess this is the mayor's desk here. Well, another warning not to approach anything even remotely resembling this diagram unless it has been disabled. And a license plate. Back report items. Mayor. Compass. Oh, a working compass. Oh, we have something. Colorado. What do we got here? 17-125 AH, Special Counsel Session 2? I guess this is 2. Discussed final approval of Farley's plan with regard to the imminent attack. The full council vote was unanimous, and I gave my final approval. The preparations update. Farley says that tunneling is almost complete. Tham informs us that the Villains will complete their construction and have started testing. Special Council Session 12. Okay, that was 11. No one attended. I will inquire as to the reason for their absence. I also had him change the upper tower access code. A clue to that code has been placed under the direction of the first mayor. And notice the color change. Important clue. Special Council Session 15. A special meeting was called to go over the plans for the final time. Farley had several instruction sheets to distribute. The Mofang weapon illustration, a list of all souls that will be used as a basis for chambering manifests. Souls. Okay. And a thorough summary of the battle plans. These will be distributed as necessary. No word from Shavar. Death is on our doorstep. Curse the Mofang devils to hell. I am leaving to be chambered. This journal will remain here to inform any future souls of what our last days were like. Okay. Well, actually, wait. There was an important clue here. We'll go back. Purple. A clue to the code has been placed under the direction of our first mayor. So, our first mayor, this is actually, I think, one of the more obscure puzzles in the game. Our first mayor was Luther Roscoe. So, if we go over here and take a look at this box, it says on there, Roscoe. If we open it up, there's a compass. Direction, get it. You get it? Under the direction is the word Colorado. And as one more subtle hint, here's a license plate for Iowa. Now, where else have we seen license plates? In the garage. So if we scoot on down to the garage, we see a lot of license plates. One of these should be Colorado. Really? Where? Oh, there we are, Colorado. BG4153. So let's take a picture of that. Because that is a code to something. I think it talked about tower access, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, in the meantime, let's get that sort of causeway over the river turned. Nice having these ways around. We can get all over the place now fairly efficiently, I think. All right, so here we are coming to our little bridge. And again, what we need to do is get this straight so that this can go across the top so we can cross across there. So we should bring this propeller. This was actually our very first puzzle we solved, really, wasn't it? Release the catch. Oh, we probably have to. Yes, that's the neutral position. This should be the turning it back the other way position. There we go. And it should stop there. It stopped that way before. Good, now we can get across there. So let's head back. Through here, and through. Through the wall that's at the other end of this should get us back to the other wall. Alright, here we go. And now we can run across here. This is definitely a Pac-Man style world we got happening here. Oh, what is... Aha, that's so we can get back up here in a less roundabout way from now on. Nice. As I was saying, this is definitely a Pac-Man style world. You end up going to the wall on one side, you end up emerging on the other side. Okay, we are coming to something here. And a code of some kind. Oh, I think. Okay, we have our license plate. Let's look at our photos here. There's my license plate picture. So there it is, BG4153. Just writing that down so I don't have to look at the pictures anymore. Close that. Back. Resume. Everyone knows how you can attach letters to phone numbers. That's why that hint there was from the lawyers. This is from a while back with the help you, and then those are the numbers. But I'm not. There are different schemes for attaching numbers, letters to phone numbers, to the digits and phone numbers. But there was a phone booth down near the garage. I was wondering what this phone booth is about. Now I think I know. So we can look at this now. We can see B is actually a 2. And G is a 4. So now it's 244153. Okay, let's head back. So this, okay, so 2 4 4 1 5, got to count, 5 3. Nice. Okay, I think that's powered up our elevator here. That code, by the way, is different with every game. The first time I played through this, I believe my state was New York, so it actually forces you to at least do something in the game. Okay, elevator up. We are at the top of the tower with a beautiful view of the tree and the town and Cecil's area. And oh, our various is Hunrath, which is Uth, Murray, which is where we were. We've yet to be to Mofang or Kaptar. Hopefully, we'll be there. But power looks like it's out to all of them. We have a screen looking down at the garage for some unknown reason. Well, we can get a nice view of this side. But that's, do it. Yeah, of course nothing happens. Imagine if you went through the real world just pushing everything you saw. Okay, so this gets us down, but I think we can go down another level. So now we're at that level. There we go. First floor. This is where we were before, the mayor's place, but there's clearly a level below. Aha! Basement. Okay, what do we got here? Oh, so that's the same exercise sheet. Somebody has been at least figuring out some things. I don't know if that's it. Now I'm thinking about it. I don't know if those numbers are meaning of anything. Let's take a picture. They might be of some meaning. Okay. Somebody might be needing those specific numbers for something. Hard to turn because of where I'm standing. Just a second. I feel like I'm turning it the wrong way. There we go. No. I'm not sure it does anything anyway. Okay, I'll give it up. But we got steps up there. Was there anything else back this way? I don't think so. Okay, let's go up here. Oh, I think I know where we are. That, I think, gives us access to the tree area. Very, very exciting. Someone's a little privy. Now, can I go down any further? Kind of looks like the depths of hell down there. Yeah. So let's go up. But I believe we now have access to the tree. Oh, yes. And he did talk about getting down to the heart of the tree, so here we go. Whoops. We did turn the water on down to here. Oh, this is trippy. And I can't travel any further. So, what do we got? 1, 2, 3 doors. 3 other worlds. That shouldn't be shocking. So, I'm suspecting these are portals to those 3 other places. To the other alien places. Mofang, Vilainzar, what's that? Moray, and I'm forgetting the other one. And this is our hose. We diverted water this way. I think I saw some sort of control. Here we are. Alright, tree. Let's make you healthy here. Aha! That's like a good thing to do. Oh, we have some sort of voltmeter. There was stuff talking about voltages and the like. It is climbing. Oh, we got power. So I think that might be all we have to do here. But methinks, well, there's a channel of it running this way. Oh, this is now colored, but I can't get through. Probably have to open it from the other side somehow. So, I believe what we need to do is find alternate ways into those other 3 worlds. But I think I'm going to end this episode here. I thank you for watching, and hope to see you again next time.